We are still in module one on solving linear equations. We are in module 1B now. Today we're going to talk about what happens when you solve a linear equation and something crazy happens, where you don't get an x equals with just a number. So we're going to talk about some vocabulary words. So first let's go to our PowerPoint of our notes. Okay, the equations that we were solving in module 1A that were linear all had solutions. You got x equals with a number. That linear equation that always has one solution is called conditional. Okay, but sometimes we're going to find out today that doesn't always happen. Sometimes you can solve a linear equation and you can actually lose your variable. Just like the little nursery rhyme, Little Bo Peep has lost her sheep. Sometimes your variable x will go away. It will cancel out. And what you'll end up with is a statement. And sometimes that statement's going to be true. So we could be solving an equation and lose the x, and we can end up with 3 equals 3. Well, that doesn't mean the answer for x is 3. Okay? So sometimes when you solve a linear equation and you lose your variable and you end up with a true statement, we call this the identity equation. And we're going to discuss what that means. A third thing can happen. Sometimes, again, like Little Bo Peep has lost her sheep, you could be solving a linear equation and lose your variable. Only this time, instead of having a true statement, you could end up with a false statement. So if you have 3 equals 4, well, that's not true. That's false. And if you have a false statement, that's called a contradiction. And we're going to talk about what that means. So we're going to look at our notes. We have 3 equations we're going to review how to solve. And then we're going to talk about what happens when you solve them. So let's go to the whiteboard. Okay, here's my first linear equation. Again, let's talk. Why is this an equation? It has an equal sign. Why is it linear? It's x to the first power, x to the first power. Our job is to solve it. Step 1, do we have any parentheses? No. Step 2, do we have any fractions or decimals? No. Step 3, can we collect like terms? Sure we can. On this left side, we could put 4x and minus x together. 4x minus 1x is 3x. Bring down the plus 1. Okay, step 4. We move the variables to what side? The left. So how do we move the 6x to the left? That's right, we do the opposite. It's an invisible plus in front of here, which means it's being added, so we subtract it. 3x minus 6x is negative 3x. Bring down your plus 1 equals, these are additive inverses, they cancel out. You're left with negative 2. Variables move to the left, so step 5 says numbers move to the right. We move adding and subtracting first, so we're going to do the opposite of add 1, which is subtract 1. There's my negative 3x. This cancels, additive inverses. A negative 2 and a negative 1, they're both negative. We add them, we get negative 3. Last thing to do is divide. The opposite of multiplying. So the opposite of multiplying by a negative 3 is to divide by a negative 3. You always divide by the number in front. What do we know about a negative divided by a negative? Hey, that makes a positive. It makes a positive 1x. We don't need the 1 in front of the x. It's understood to be there. It's connected by multiplication. Negative 3 divided by negative 3, again, I know you want to cancel them out, but you got to leave something on that right side. Something divided by itself. Any number divided by itself is 1. So a negative divided by a negative is positive. 3 divided by 3 is 1. If you look here, we have one solution, just like we did in module 1A. When you have one solution, this is called a conditional linear equation. It's got one answer. We know we could check that by substituting it in. So if we substitute it in, we put a 1 here. 4 times 1 is 4. 4 plus 1 is 5. We'd also put a 1 here. So 5 minus 1, this side would be 4. We'd put the 1 here. 6 times 1 is 6 minus 2, that would be 4. It balances. So most of the times when you're solving a linear equation, when you get your one solution, which is what we normally are used to getting, we call that a conditional linear equation. But that doesn't always happen. So let's go to example 2. Here's my linear equation. What's the first thing we got to do, guys? That's right. We got to distribute to get rid of parentheses. 2 times negative 5x is negative 10x. 2 times 1 is 2. 2 times negative 1 is negative 2. The left, right side we bring down. Okay, there's nothing to collect here. They're not alike. They're not alike. So now we move our variable to what side? The left. So I'm going to do the opposite of subtract 10x, which is add 10x. Uh-oh. When you subtract 10x and add 10x, because they're additive inverses, opposites, they cancel out. That leaves you negative 2. Uh-oh. When you subtract 10x and add 10x, they're opposites. They're additive inverses, so they cancel out. That leaves you positive 6. Now, everybody look closely. Do you see an x up here? No, you do not. This does not say the answer is x is negative 2. This does not say the answer is x is 6. This is a statement. And what happens, like little Bo Peep lost her sheep? If you lose your variable, you're going to either end up with a true or false statement. So what is this? Is this true or false? Well, does negative 2 equal 6? No, that's false. Now, this is important. That's not the answer. This is what you got to memorize. When we are solving equations, if we lose our variable, if we get a false statement, what that always means is there is no answer. There is no number you could put in for x on the left and the right that will make it balance. And the word for answer is what again? Solution. So this is where you use the famous phrase, there is no solution. Does anybody know the symbol for no solution? It's the zero with the slash. That's why in math you can't write that and tell me it's the number zero. It's not a number. That is a symbol for this word, this phrase. And you only use this phrase when you cannot solve an equation. So guys, every time you're solving, if you lose your variable and get a false statement, there will never be an answer. And what that means is no matter what number you pick, if you put that number in place of x on the left and in place of x on the right, it will never balance. There's no number that's going to make this balance. Okay? We have one more example to look at. Oh, before I forget, what do we call this? If having a solution is called conditional, having no solution, having a false statement, is called a contradiction. And think about what that word means in real life in English. A contradiction is something that doesn't agree. That doesn't agree. So every time you end up with a contradiction, your answer will always be no solution. There is no answer to make this work. Okay, let's look at our third one on our notes. Our third equation is real simple. It's 3x minus 6 equals 3 parentheses x minus 2. It's a linear equation. Our job is to solve it. So we follow our procedure. You get rid of parentheses first. So on the right side, 3 times x is 3x. 3 times negative 2 is negative 6. You don't have fractions or decimals. You don't collect like terms. They're not alike. They're not alike. So now we move the variable to the left. So we're going to do the opposite of add 3x, which is subtract 3x. What happens to 3x minus 3x? You're right, it makes 0. It cancels out. So we don't need to write it. We just bring down the negative 6. On the right side, 3x minus 3x is 0. But we don't need to write it because 0 minus 6 is still negative 6. So again, look at what happened. Like little Bo Peep has lost her sheep, you have lost your variable. This does not say x equals negative 6. There is no x. So that's not what this is telling you. When you lose your variable in solving equations, you're either going to end up with a true statement or a false statement. So everybody look, is this true or false? Negative 6 equals negative 6. Obviously, that's true. It balanced. It's the same number. Well, this is what you got to memorize. When you're solving equations and you end up with a true statement, it's the opposite answer of a false statement. So think about this, guys. A false statement meant there was no answer. There's no number you could plug in here to make it balance. Well, the opposite of having no answer is having many answers. A true statement means that all numbers work. All numbers are the solution. And I don't know if you remember, but vocabulary is very important. What do you call all the numbers on the number line? That's right, they're called real numbers. So when you get a true statement, it means all real numbers. That's the answer. The answer is not just any one number that works, all the real numbers work. I'll prove it to you. Pick out a number on the number line. I'm going to pick 4. If I put 4 here, 3 times 4 is 12. 12 minus 6 is 6. If I put 4 here, 4 minus 2 is 2. 3 times 2 is 6. It balanced. You could pick a totally different number and it will still be balanced. So you have to memorize. If you end up with a true statement, that means all real numbers work. And if you want to be fancy, the symbol for the word real is this fancy R. And you'll see that in college algebra. They use that R to mean real numbers. If you get a true statement, you call this equation an identity. Identity means it looks the same. It looks the same. So now you've learned when you're solving equations that are linear, not always are you just going to have x equals with a number. That's what we're mostly used to. That's our normal conditional linear equation. Sometimes you can solve a linear equation that has no solution. Sometimes you can solve a linear equation that has all real numbers as a solution. Okay, I'll get you next on the next module.